Structs are a great way to encapsulate values, but we can take this one step further. Let's modify the original syntax for creating a struct. Right now, we know that a struct has the struct keyword, and then we give the name of the struct, followed by variables or constants of any type, as many as we want, and these are known as properties. So I'm going to go ahead and make a quick change to this. Here's the difference. With this syntax, we can see that a struct can not only contain variables and constants, but instances of any type. That means you can have structs that contain structs that contain structs. Essentially, structs on structs on structs. Let's say we have this struct representing a song, and inside the struct we have a property for the song's title, its length, and also properties for the artist's first and last name. So as we define a struct like this, maybe we decide that we want to include some more information about the artist, like their age and their hometown. We can go ahead and add these properties, like so, but this is beginning to look exactly like the problem we had before structs. We just have a bunch of variables and constants, and they're starting to get a little disorganized, and all this related information could continue to grow and get more unmanageable. The best way to handle this is by pulling the artist's data out of the song struct and creating a separate struct that represents an artist. There we go. Now we have an artist struct with first name, last name, age, and hometown. And actually, we could probably get rid of this prefix because that would be redundant. Now here's the powerful part. Within the song struct, we can have our own property, which itself is a struct. So let's do that now. So now the song struct itself contains an artist, and this is really nice and elegant. And as we'll see later, expanding this to support multiple artists is actually a quite intuitive process as well. So how would we access the properties of a struct within a struct? Let's go ahead and see a code example to explain. First, we'll create an artist struct. How about country music artist Garth Brooks? We will use the syntax we've seen before. For the first name, we've given Garth. For the last name, Brooks. Age 53 and hometown is Tulsa, Oklahoma. And this is according to Wikipedia when I looked it up a couple minutes ago. And now that we have our artist struct, creating a song struct becomes pretty simple. Let's create a struct for his song, Thunder Rolls. So we'll use the song name Thunder Rolls, which has a length of 342. And we could represent this as a number, but we're choosing to do it as a string for right now. And the last property that this initializer needs is an artist. And lo and behold, we have this artist instance right here called Garth. So we'll use Garth. And there we go. We have an instance of a song struct. Now, to access the information about the artist contained within is pretty straightforward, and it uses the dot operator again. So we'll start with Thunder Rolls, then dot, artist. And if we go and we look to see what it contains, we can see all the properties of the artist within. And if we want to take this one step further, we can use another dot operator to access one of the properties within artist, like last name in this case, which is Brooks. So I'm sure you can start thinking of some pretty complex and cool relationships of structs within structs.